So what's up, guys? Today we are going to make a really awesome cauliflower ground turkey mix called gobi keema. Keema is traditionally more like lamb meat or beef. I have seen it goat meat. We're gonna use ground turkey because this is America and let's face it, better for you. But so all we're gonna need is our spices, which will go, I'll let you know as we go. I mean, basically it's gonna be turmeric and a coriander cumin mix, dried ground up that I've got. And that's about it. Maybe a little jalapeno powder. There's actually no need for salt or any of that. And then we'll top it off with a little hot sauce maybe to taste. But really, the main ingredients, all you're gonna need is 2 pounds of ground turkey and an entire head of cauliflower, leaves and all. All right, you ready? Okay. First things first, we are going to set this puppy onto high heat. High. And notice I'm using a big pot. That's just gonna help us, it's gonna take a lot of surface area and it's gonna help things not flat around. Another thing you're gonna notice that I'm doing is today, and I'm just doing this challenge, so really you should use a spatula. I'm using this ladle simply because it's out, because we made some curry in our last episode. But you're gonna see this episode a month later. But really, I just don't want to make extra dishes. So we're gonna reuse that, and it's gonna be a nice challenge. It's gonna be fun for me, but you know, make extra dishes. All right, so this pan is heating up. There's no need for oil, no need for any of that jazz, because even as close to fat-free turkey as you can find, it's gonna have more fat than you. So, yeah, dump that 2 pounds of turkey in there, and kind of let it go, All right, while that is going on, we are going to cut this puppy up. Now, rather big knife. I'm going to want to cut this up, and you'll see, cut it up like that, and we're going to cut it up into multiple little pieces, just like that, and like that, and I'm going to actually use the leaves. Yeah, look at it, just shoots off. Oh, cutting cauliflower makes such a mess. All right, so we're not taking up too much of your time. This is just gonna make you this ridiculous mess. All right, so let's, every now and then we're gonna turn back to the turkey, we're gonna mash it up and move it around. Then we're gonna cut some cauliflower, we're gonna go back to the turkey, mash it up and move it around. Like this. Make sure it gets some, all the surface area, and make sure it is cooked thoroughly. It all should be brown. There should be absolutely no pink left whatsoever. For your own health safety. Okay. Now you might decide like me, that cutting a cauliflower up with a knife just makes too much of a mess. If you so desire, which is what I'm going to switch to next, we're gonna break it up with our hands over the pot as soon as the turkey's ready. Let's keep mushing this puppy up, keep it going. All right, you can see what I mean by not needing any oil whatsoever. The fat has come out, and this was 85 to 95% fat-free turkey, and there's still a lot of fat coming out of it. Don't need to grease the pan at all. All right, so now that we've got it, it's half pink, half brown. Now that we've got it kind of halfway cooked, we're gonna start adding the cauliflower. Just toss it in there, break it up into pieces like this with your hand if you didn't use the knife, which is my preference because any mess it makes just kind of goes right in the pot where it belongs. Versus when you start cutting cauliflower with a knife, cauliflower bits fly all over the place and you gotta mop the kitchen floor and the counter's a mess. It's kind of easier to break it up. If your pot is big enough, you can also just throw the whole head of cauliflower in there and just beat it. Just beat at it. That in there. And look at that, just touching cauliflower makes it create a gigantic, outrageous mess. That is looking great. Looking great. Cauliflower is so fragile. Look how cool that looks. Your giant plant brain. God, I love this stuff. And it's interesting, you're gonna notice how it's so nice and white right now. But as soon as I start adding the right amount of the turmeric, you're gonna get this beautiful yellow color, which is indicative of almost any Indian dish, that turmeric, nice yellow color. So I use this, just kind of break it up. Use all of it. So I'm gonna toss this in like that. Yes, we are using the whole head of cauliflower. 2 pounds of turmeric. Careful not to touch your hands to the side and burn yourself. Remember, the heat is still on high. And all that turkey fat is cooling to the bottom. Nice. Cut right into the pan. Easy way. Beautiful. As long as you get it all in there. But don't worry about cutting up the leaves too much. It's going to cook down like you wouldn't believe. So, stick that in there. Now let's add some of my favorites. We're going to use turmeric. This is Haldi's. Fresh ground dried Haldi turmeric. Bright yellow. Make sure it doesn't land on anything. It stains. This is a coriander and cumin powder that my mother made, actually. It's a nice mix. And this is dried jalapeno powder. We're only going to use a little bit of this. All right. So, first things first, we're going to add a teaspoon of the turmeric. Yeah, nice and beautifully yellow. It's so good for you. I mean, it's amazing. It's amazing how good for you it is. Using the same spoon, we're going to add a nice heaping teaspoon of this tablespoon size. So I'm using a little more than half of this, even of this coriander cumin mix. You don't need the coriander, you can go straight to cumin. Roasted is good. It's called jeera if you're at an Indian store. Alright, and then I'm just going to add just a little pinch of the jalapeno powder. It's totally optional. Okay, and once we got all that in there, we're going to stir things up all nice and good. Alright, so at this point, it is safe to turn us down to a simmer, low heat. Anywhere between medium to low is fine. We don't need the full high heat anymore. At this point, the turkey is probably cooked on the bottom. And just, again, I'm using the ladle to make it harder on myself. This will be so easy for you with a spatula. You just want to move things around until it cooks down and let it simmer in there. What I also might do, which you might want to consider, is I'm going to put a splash of lemon juice in here. Just a splash. Okay? And let it simmer here and cook down. You'll know because the cauliflower is soft. It should take 6 to 7 minutes. Alright, so this is 10 minutes later on the low to medium simmer heat. And it's awesome. You can tell there's no actual fat left on there because all the turkey fat that was in there went into the cauliflower. The turkey is a nice cooked, semi-dry consistency, and it goes well with this fantastically juicy cauliflower. It's both soft but still has bite. Look how nice and yellow it is. So this can be eaten by itself with some rotis on the side. That's how you would traditionally probably eat something like this. I actually like to put it in tacos. Believe it or not, it tastes great in tacos or burritos. And another thing that is great to do is to toss a little yogurt in there. And a little yogurt, especially Greek yogurt. But regular yogurt is actually, as far as I'm concerned, better for you. Maybe a little less in protein if you're going to get better probiotic consistency in regular yogurt. So a little regular yogurt in here. It's going to, look at that. It's great. A little regular yogurt and some hot sauce, and you have got yourself like a nice casserole-y type dish. It's fantastic. It's so versatile. All right, so... enjoy.